Now we go to turbulent kinetic energy. Remember, have you seen this just now? TKE, turbulent kinetic energy. So kinetic energy in general is just this. Do you remember the kinetic energy equation from physics? It's half mv squared. And this is energy, kinetic. But here, what you studied was just the velocity, the speed in the form of scalar. There's no direction. But in turbulence, there's three directions. So to extend this to turbulence, you just need to account for all three components. So it's just an addition of this. It's half m, then u squared plus v squared, w squared, that's all. This is just for one component. This is for all three components. So if you have this u star, v squared, w squared, and you do this, and you can calculate the kinetic energy for that turbulent flow. But you might ask yourself, how about this mass here? Do I need to calculate the mass all the time? But notice that the mass doesn't change. It's just air, right? So we can bring this mass over here. It becomes E over M. It's just a matter of squaring the velocity. That means whatever energy we have is just per mass. So it's like joules per kg. Usually we don't care about the mass of air. We just care about the velocity component because in the end, the mass doesn't change that much. So remember, turbulence is made up of U, it's made up of the averaging part plus the turbulent part. So the mean kinetic energy is just the average squared, while this is the turbulent kinetic energy. The combination of this and this is kinetic energy. If you just focus on this, is the mean energy, the turbulent kinetic energy. If you just focus on this, it's the mean kinetic energy. So, going back to the intensity of turbulence, how turbulence is, it can be quantified. So, we use U as an example. So, the intensity of turbulence in the U direction is then defined by the variance. It's just this. So ui minus u bar squared divided by n. And that is the turbulence intensity. So again, this is the variance average over a half hour period. So this variance value can vary slowly with time over subsequent averaging periods. So this one will change depending with time. So similar equations can be defined for other velocity components to obtain sigma v squared and sigma w squared for the different components.